each new atrocity is an echo of a pistol fired long ago in the depth of a dry well. It took 24 hours to bring the monster down. Two knife wounds need medical attention. The nest of the gang was out of time. The only loose end is the driver of Buster's meds and $400,000 in charity money. Gotham's the largest city in the country, but my Buster knows it's not big enough to keep him safe from me. True to form, Buster is running, but he can't hide. Last night, I pursued Buster. That is, was his last interest to tell me where the Joker was. Somehow, he pulled a fast one on his loss and made off with the money. But I've been keeping tails on him. My tracking device indicates he's heading this way, and odds are he crossed this bridge on his way uptown. Suddenly my knees go slack, and I grail on some wall. I stand there, shaking, ready for it all to go past. And I feel the nagging, monotonically crowd out more pressing thoughts. I realized long ago that I can't change the world. And in 3 years, I came to realize that I can appreciably change the city. I began to wonder if the only thing I can change is myself. The shaking stops long enough for me to pull myself up to the top level of the bridge. The wind cuts through the thermals and I look at the bright side. At least my shoulder is too numb to feel. The city's impartial gauge darts across my back. Is it realistic? This obsession, is it sane? I drop the introspection. It's time to go to work. I'm tired of men like Buster, morally bankrupt and unimaginative, empty, meaningless men, feeding off my city and controlling nothing. I'm about to leap down onto the hood of his car and scare the pants off him when the unexpected happens. Why would he stop in the middle of the bridge? He stares at the top of the parapet, and a look steals over his face that I can't put my finger on. I watch him climb the face of the wall, and it hits me. He must have the money stashed up there. Just when I think this is going to wrap itself up nice and neat and unravels into the irrational, it's not the money he's going to jump. Pain gone, exhaustion gone, there's only adrenaline and a target. No time to think, just a fraction of a second for me to realize that there's nowhere to tie the rope. It feels as though my bad arm is going to tear away from my body. Until I compare to the exquisite pain of hitting concrete at 35 miles per hour. Sloppy, painful, but effective. Buster's gratitude warms my heart.
No!
I consider leaving him to hang while I quietly pass out. It takes everything I got to pull him up. He whirls at me, eyes blazing with hate.
Last night you threatened me to drop me off a rooftop and tonight stop me? What's the matter, fruitcake? Can't make up your mind.
He's wild, unpredictable. Got to pull myself together and try to stand up. The wave of dizziness hits me. He's reaching for something. Vision blur and then clears.
Don't move, you freak!
Joker's been put away, Buster. You're safe now.
Safe? You idiot. Who do you think you are dealing with? How many times has he been caught? Your mom's always let him escape. Chucky's old gave me the word. The Joker knows I write him off. He wanted me to know that when he gets out, he will be looking me and my family up to show his appreciation. You self-writer's nut. You used me in your little game of cops and robbers, but the Joker will never get his hand on any of my family. I couldn't bear the thought of my wife and my daughter in the hands of that maniac. So I'll kill them myself. I'll see you in hell, you mask lunatic.
Buster, no!
Father, I have to tell you something.
I told them about a man named Buster Smiths. A man who had a wife and child. By the time I'm done, my body is wrecked with uncontrollable sobbing. They remain frozen through it all, as if they were hanging on my every word, urging me to discover the center of this grief, to heal it from the inside out. In the past, whenever I had lost hope and the darkness closed in on me, the power of the cave and the undying spirit of my parents will bear me up and fuel me with the strength to carry on. But as dawn's brittle fingers steal across the frozen ground to herald a new morning, I find that this time it's not enough.
I can't do it. Not anymore.
A wave of relief passes over me, and I feel the beast hold on me slip away. For the first time in 20 years, I am at peace. That feeling lasts for exactly 20 seconds.
You fool! You think you know pain, you coward? I will show you pain.
I'm not sure how, not sure why, but as my heart floods through with terror, I am sure of one thing. I am facing myself.
Sprung a leaf. Sprung a leak, and the animals I've trained.